The impulses settings defines how many valid left and right impulses are required before the test stops automatically. Here you see 20 left head impulses and 20 right head impulses. To change the number of suggested minimum head impulses for the current testing session, click the up and down arrows or type the number in directly. The maximum value is 999. 20 has been recommended by Drs. Homolgi and Kurthoys as the minimum number that should be collected for both left and right side. For patients with spontaneous nystagmus, select the checkbox, Patient has spontaneous nystagmus. This prevents good impulses from being rejected inappropriately. The elapsed time displays along with the test date and test time at the bottom of the window. While performing the head impulse test, both the real-time trace window and the lateral impulse window display head and eye traces to assist you in understanding the quality of data being collected. There are algorithms built into the system that will reject bad head impulses. While you are doing the head impulse testing, you will want to look at the real-time trace window and the lateral impulse window. The real-time trace window allows you to monitor both head, displayed in red, and eye movement displayed in green, while performing one head impulse test. By monitoring the real-time trace, you can make sure the patient is cooperating and staring at the fixation dot. The lateral impulse window helps you perform good head impulses. The gray training lines represent the shape of good head impulses at a variety of velocities, 50, 100, 150, and 200. Positive velocities represent leftward head impulses. Negative velocities represent rightward head impulses. The actual head and eye trace are superimposed on top of the gray training lines. The eye trace is always represented in green. White dots display along the y-axis to indicate the velocity of impulses collected. Comparing the actual traces against the training lines helps ensure that the tester performs quality head impulses and that only good data is included in the analysis. The collection algorithm assures that only good head impulses are accepted for analysis. When performing the head impulse, you want to make sure it is randomized. Perform multiple velocities and randomized left and rightward movements. You want to make sure the patient cannot predict which direction and at what velocity the head impulse will be performed. Touching the goggles or the goggle strap while moving the patient's head can result in moving the camera, which produces artifacts in the collection data. Again, it is important the goggles are strapped on tight and do not move during testing. Standing behind the patient, place your hands on top of the patient's head, well away from the goggles and the goggle strap. Ask the patient to stare at the fixation dot. Perform the head impulse by moving the head abruptly in a very quick motion like a kick. The tester should imagine a target point about 15 to 20 degrees to the right or left of the patient's head, straight ahead of them. The tester should try to turn the patient's head so that the patient's nose is pointing at the imaginary spot, moving it abruptly, trying not to overshoot the 15 or 20 degrees and trying not to have a return, just a quick direct head turn to the imagined target point. Hold it there for a few seconds and then slowly bring the head back to straight ahead or facing the wall. The key bit of feedback for the tester is that the movement should be precise. It should go up and come back to baseline with very little overshoot. If the head velocity looks like a sine wave, then you are doing it right. Look at your head impulses and compare them to the training curves. The head impulses should be presented in an unpredictable manner in direction and at varying velocities. After each head impulse is performed, you should look at the lateral impulse window and see if the head impulse you perform matches the training curves. Note how the head movement matches the gray training curve. Also note the white dot indicating the velocity at which it was performed and whether the head impulse was accepted or rejected. The system automatically stops when the minimum numbers for left and right impulses have been reached. To manually stop the test, click Stop. Data collection will be saved. Or Cancel. Data collection will not be saved. The data is automatically analyzed and displayed in the 2D analysis window. Let's look at some of my first head impulse results. Here you can see the difference in results from practice. These three sessions took about 10 to 15 minutes, and by watching the training curves, there was instant improvement. Look at the head velocity in trial 1, especially on the left side. They do not align well. Same in trial 2, but in trial 3, both the left and the right velocities align quite well. Now let's look at common mistakes. Here is an example of a head impulse that was performed too slowly. Notice that the tracing is broad and does not match the training curve. In this second example, the head impulse was performed at the correct speed, but the return was too quick. After performing the head impulse, you need to hold it there for a few seconds and then slowly bring the head back to the straight position. Regarding analysis of the data collected, the video will not cover understanding head impulse analysis. I refer you back to the user manual for this. We want to make one more comment regarding data collection. The analysis algorithm evaluates the good head impulses and ensures that the patient was performing the task appropriately. For example, if the tester performs a good head impulse, then the data is saved. But if the patient happened to blink or is looking around during the good head impulse, the analysis algorithm then discards the data as not being valid. Therefore, in the analysis section under the test info tab, you see the data that was collected as well as the data that was actually analyzed. You may find that some of the collected data was not analyzed. There are two algorithms to assure that good data is collected.